Welcome back to some more Grand Theft Auto 5, everybody. Looks like our bureau friends want to discuss something with us. We just got all cleaned up. We're still looking a little thumped up, but hey, we took it like a man. Alright, so our bureau friends want to discuss something with us, huh? Well, let's, Let's go to Solomon, then. Oh! I think I just killed that person. That's what they get for pulling out in front of me. I got business to take care of. Come on back here, because this is where he's at.
Set some fat fucking old jackass on me, please! Big man! We had a deal! We had paperwork!
Hey!
Fuck off, Johnny!
Hey, you're a couple real badasses! Put a beat down on an old man!
Yeah, we don't take that! We have a deal with them!
Just about. Please. Get those millennial ass wipes.
Pleasure. You fuck what? Where are you going, tough guys?
Okay, here we go. Eliminate Rocco.
Oh, no, fuck.
Sorry about the car, dude. It handles like crap. See if we can catch up to this guy. Oh my god! Come on, turn, let's go! This car handles like freaking butt. I wonder if I can get a sticky bomb on their car.
Down, you loopy prick.
Oh my god, this freaking car.
Pull off, old man.
I guess I didn't make it clear to you at the
okay.
Car.
I guess I couldn't get it off in time. This is extremely hard to shoot and drive.
This is how you do business? You demented old asshole! You wrinkly asswipe!
Gosh dang it. Come on. We've almost got these guys.
to retire you.
Oh my god, seriously, they freaking turn around? These guys are getting real annoying.
You've gone crazy! Oh shit! We're connected! Slow down, you loopy prick! I told you to stay away!
Come on, stick your head up, dude.
How you like me now?
I'll take that. I don't want to take your broke down car. Time to go. Wow, that was a freaking cluster.
I'm only a paraplegic, but you can't feel anything.
Yeah, you're throwing me softballs. The rum runner. But speaking of accidents, those guys had one.
Oh, if only we'd met 20 years ago, Michael, maybe I wouldn't be in this mess.
Yeah, you and me both, brother.
Look, it's a pain, I know, but could you come by the studio now? I got something I'd like to show you.
Hey, dude, what's up?
Yeah, of course, I'll be right over.
Yeah, we'll go check it out. I mean, we do have the guy's car after all. Alright, let's see what he's got to show us. Better be something interesting.
Come in!
Come in! Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah, turns out maybe I'm cut out for the movie business after all, huh?
My friend, you're a sentimental thug with zero artistic training and nothing interesting to say. I would say you're overqualified. Anyway, shut up and take a look at that.
Whoa.
Oh. Oh. Fucking A.
Feels good, doesn't it?
Feels like I've finally done something with my life. Actually done something. A movie.
Welcome to show business. Nothing but make-believe will ever feel quite real again. All right, Michael, come on. Let me show you some rushes. I think you're gonna love it, but it'd be great to hear your notes.
Hey, baby, I just wanted to tell you, I'm finally doing something with my life. I'm making a movie, a real one. Call me.
And all Michael's trying to do is do good for his family. You can't blame him for that. Can't blame him for that at all. All right, well, we got to go head to Lester. Our FIB boys would like to speak to me. So let's go head over there.
Start up, you piece of shit.
Maybe I should find myself a better vehicle. This thing's having some issues starting up here. Yeah, this thing doesn't sound very healthy. I think I'll have your car. I need to borrow this.
Coolio, baby. It's just a car.
There we go. Much better. We can't be rolling around in a thug car. It's all trashed up, and we're producers.
Thank you.
Oh, I dented my car. Okay, let's see what we got going on here now.
What's going on?
Oh, just enjoying a little labor dispute. See, we're about to do something really, really bad. So I need to present myself as a proper textile magnate. So
you stopped making anything?
Nothing looks more suspicious in America than someone who's actually prepared to make something.
Jesus.
What about you?
Oh, fucking Trevor. We're having some problems.
Brad.
Yeah, what else?
Anyway, the union depository is on hold for now. Can't do it without him, especially now that he knows.
Thank God you guys are here. You alone?
Davey, where's your boyfriend, Steve?
He's on his way up. Yeah, they're up here. Listen, the shit's about to hit the fan.
Our entire lives together has been nothing but a series of fans and shits.
Sort this problem out for me, and I will get Mr. Leisureware off your back.
And if we don't?
Then I will go to jail and you will get shot.
Ah, fuck you, Dave. I've heard it all before.
Not like this, you haven't.
Has he briefed you?
Oh, well, yes, he has. He told us that if we do what you say, then together we can take down the big bad wolf that is government corruption.
Yeah, and if you don't, we're all gonna fry, because the agency's onto us. I've even got some fools in our own bureau that are questioning my methods. Think I'm a liar, a cheater, some kind of a killer and a thief.
So?
So, there's some evidence, and I need you guys to find out what they know.
All right, so what? You want Lester here to hack into the system, wipe it all clean?
Oh, no, that will not work. The only way to access it is through your buildings.
Fuck me.
Michael. You'd be doing me a very big favor. And if you do this, I will make sure that all your files are deleted. I promise you.
Hey! It's the last thing we do, and we're done. Period.
Of course! I'm a man of my word! Dave, let's go!
Come on, Lester, let's go.
Good luck, gentlemen.
So this is it, huh? He's a man of his word, he says.
Take us to the FIB building, parking lot entrance.
You suck!
So, you got any idea how we'll do this? Scope it out?
Not really, but I thought we'd start by finding a way into the building.
We're going in through the parking lot?
No. We're waiting for someone to come out of it. A janitor.
All right. And how's that gonna get us in?
Well, the janitors are all on temp contracts. They get replaced when their backs go or they ask for a day off. So, we find one of these guys, we turn him, and that's our in.
Okay. Their particular guy?
I'm in the temp company's database right now. I found a guy about to clock off. I got the file here. Let me see. Harvey Molina, license plate 83QSL722. And we'll follow him and see what we think. You should be coming out here soon.
I think my hood just broke off my car.
That's it? Not our guy.
So, what do you think about this whole messed up situation?
I think they'll either kill you after this is done, or keep you doing these stupid jobs until they don't have to kill you because someone else has done it for them.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Oh, here's another one.
Here we go. Nope.
So what do we do?
What can we do? We do the job. And maybe you can delete the files when you're inside doing whatever else you're doing. That might be a way out.
Yeah, well, a way out is exactly what I need.
I think that's a better way to go, just delete the files when I'm in there.
Something's coming. That's not it. It's hard to get motivated on a job without financial incentive.
You can't put a price on freedom.
Well, that spur won't be there for the crew. I'm gonna ask Mr. Haynes for a budget. Maybe the leftover cash from the Polito score. We need something.
Yeah, see what you can do.
We made off pretty good on that Polito score, that's for sure.
Ooh, what's this? This is not the car we're looking for.
Still not the car, huh? What is this guy doing? Taking a smoke break up there?
That's the one. You know the drill. Couple of car lengths.
So what's gonna happen when this guy gets wherever he's going?
He's gonna get his severance package.
I can't tell if that's some creepy euphemism or a plain statement of facts.
It's whatever you want it to be.
Okay.
Take the next right.
Hey, you mind? Put away the smartphone or pad or whatever the hell that is for a minute. No surfing while I'm trying to tail this guy.
It's work-related.
Yeah, well, I'd prefer all hands on deck right now, if it's okay with you. God, you're worse than my son.
You want to break into the FIB's West Coast headquarters, you're gonna need more than a janitor's license plate number. Now let me work on some angles while you, keep this car behind that one in between these white lines.
That's it. I mean, other than a few missing expletives in terms of racial abuse, that was my son in spades.
Why is that guy taking pictures of my beat-up car?
I just spoke with Agent Haynes. We've got the budget to pull this off.
Good.
Could we seriously not hit every single red light known to man?
Hey, Jackie.
Come on. What do we do when he gets home? What do we need from him?
We need cooperation, and maybe his overalls and an ID.
And if he don't cooperate?
You know what it's like to clean up shit for Steve Haynes? He'll cooperate.
Oh my gosh, another red...
He's gone left there, you see?
Okay, he went through the red light. Just gotta tail him for a little bit longer. It's getting a little chilly outside.
Noisy much? Ugh.
We'll know it when we fucked up.
My God, is he home yet? What is he doing? There he is, right there.
He's pulling up. Park down the block.
That ride is swagged out.
Time to make Harvey an offer. Feel him out.
Hey, Marilyn. How's that cable connection coming along?
Fine, fine. Sorry, look, I'm busy.
Only when she needs something. Jesus.
We're getting too close to the janitor. Follow the janitor into his apartment. All right.
You got another one of those, Harvey?
Who are you?
The guy with your best interests at heart. I'll fill your pockets with money, and all you got to do is take a little vacation.
Hey, I work two jobs, man. Take any break I can get.
Good.
Hey, you want the beer?
Nah, just take the overalls. Oh, and your ID.
It's in there.
Oh, and Harvey, I probably don't need to say this, but you don't play ball? I'll be forced to do something I really don't want to do. Enjoy your beer.
That was simple enough. I didn't even have to ask twice. I like people like that.
Successful?
Oh yeah.
Take me back to the factory.
I could have done that by myself without having to take you from the factory.
Yes, you were right. Steve Haynes is a shitty boss.
Hey, I called Frank while you were in there. He's coming to meet us.
Yeah, huh? What do we need him for?
Grunt work. Information gathering.
What information?
The plans to the office. There aren't any digital copies, or if there are, I'm not clever enough to find them. The architect is LS-based, so I thought Frank could tail him, take a hard copy.
Sounds complicated. You sure you need these plans?
Yeah, I do. If I'm gonna find a way to bypass a couple of $100 million worth of government security.
Millions? They blew that much?
Government contracts. License to steal.
Wow. We are in the wrong business.
Ah, he's already here.
Hey, what's the problem, dog?
Steve fucking Haynes.
Of course it's Steve fucking Haynes. It's always Steve Haynes.
That is not strictly true. It's either Steve Haynes or it's Trevor. It's his family. It's always one of them.
Yeah, that's true. It is always one of them. A fat old fuck with a horrible family and even worse friends. I told you, Franklin, I ain't a good role model.
Period. Yeah, whatever, dog. It's either this or dealing dime bags. The bullets come cracking at your ass either way.
We need to find out something about this FIB building, a weakness or a way in. Next time I meet a morally destitute, totally delusional, highly corrupt government agent. I hope he's a nice one.
I'm not going in that motherfucker by myself.
No, 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 no. Nobody is going in. We need to do some recon. We need a little more information.
She.
I need the architectural plans, but they're not online anyway, so I'm going to need paper copies. Now, the architect's name is Chip Peterson. This was his first big commission, and the office is down in Backlot City.
All right. Franklin, you go tell him for a little while, and then we'll talk.
All right, dog, I got you.
Try not to hurt yourself.
Oh, good, good, good.
Very nice. Okay, so Franklin's gonna go tell that guy to try and get those plans. What do we need to do in the meantime? I wonder if we need to take over Franklin and get those plans.
Still doing the grunt work.
Find the architect. Let's see. I think we'll go back to Michael. It doesn't look like he's got a whole lot going on here. We'll go back to Michael and go head up to his house, it looks like. Is that still heading to his house? Let me make sure. Yes, it is. Okay. We're still good. This car is not sounding too healthy now either. That could have went a lot worse. And could have gone a lot better.
You know how much this car costs?
I wouldn't know. We didn't pay for it. We borrowed it. In the meantime, oh,
but hey,
I'm sorry I spiked you. Okay, I get so mad and I can't control things, and then you know shit just falls on top of me. My life sucks right now, and I don't know what to do except I want to say I love you and hug it out. But all that wimpy shit is just. Well, I'd say gay, but I have some friends who are gay, so that's not cool anymore. And the ones that I don't really like, it's not because they're gay. So, lame, all right? You are just a lame and angry psycho sometimes. You do bad shit and things. I don't know if I love you, and I'm pretty sure I hate you a little bit, but I'm just so fucking upset that we can't even see each other. And you're just a drunk, lame dad.
You know what? That might just be the nicest thing anybody's ever said to me.
So will you buy me a car?
What?
I mean, not in the so will you buy me a car kind of way, in a completely off topic, can you buy me a car? I mean, firstly, I'm a fat shit that you ruined. And secondly, I will get a job and I will stop smoking pot in that sort of way, okay?
I love you too, son. Now, go. Get a job, because I don't have the money to buy you a car. Besides which way, I'm probably gonna be dead in a couple weeks anyway.
Please don't die, okay? Yeah, it's great catching up with you too, Dad.
Yeah. Hey, how's your mother?
Oh, she's great. No, she's not. She's bored. I mean, all this mesmerizing tantric sex she's been having with a much younger, better built, caring and compassionate man is great and all. What's she gonna do for the other 6 hours of the day?
What the fuck?
I'm just winding you up, you miserable bastard. She's mad at you. She's scared that you're gonna die, and she wants you to go over there and prove that you give a fuck.
All right. I can take a fucking hint. Let's go. We'll get Tracy on the way.
Tracy, on the other hand, she's a star. Sort of.
I think Mom's at Bean Machine.
All right, let's go to Bean Machine then. Hurry up. Get in.
So, what's been happening?
You know, I don't know. Stuff?
No, I don't know.
Well, what's been happening with you?
Thanks. It's been... It's
anyone's guess.
Yeah. Yeah, I get it.
Oh, okay. Here they are. Come on, let's say hi.
Let's walk up and be civil.
Oh, Caffeine. Come on. Your curling has been sluggish for weeks.
A little bit less... excuse me, I'm trying to write a screenplay.
Shush,
here.
Woman.
Hey, Amanda. Fabian.
Michael.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Jimmy.
These two, a picture of holistic well-being, I don't think.
Hey.
Maybe they shit once a year between them.
Hey, oh! That's my son!
Amanda, come. I have a new unitard on hold. You must pay for it.
Hey!
Hey!
Buddy,
I'm gonna ask politely that you show my wife a little respect.
Red meat has been blocking your chi as well as your digestive tract.
I ain't even gonna go there. I'm gonna ask you one time, nicely.
Michael, just hit him, please.
Shush, woman!
Anything for you, sweetheart.
What are you doing? I had some really good work there, you dick!
There's a lot more where that came from, Holmes.
Is he alive?
Yeah, he's fine. Listen, Amanda. I'm meaning to say to you, look,
what he's trying to say, Mom, is that he's a pathetic, old, drunken mess, and he needs you. And you could do a lot better than a prima donna yoga instructor with an anal fixation.
Did someone say...
Shut up!
I guess we could try.
All I'm asking for is a shot.
Neutral ground. Dr. Friedlander's office.
It's perfect. All of us. I'll pick up Tracy and bring her there. Meet you?
Fine. All right, you. Come on. Get up, you idiot.
Yoga?
No. No yoga.
All right. You know where your sister is, right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Wait. But what about that sugar, caffeine, and emulsified pig fat flavored beverage I want?
Another time.
Oh.
Come on. I want one, too. Later.
I think Tracy's over at the tattoo.
Okay, to the tattoo parlor we go.
What? Tracy's getting another tattoo.
No, oh God, no. That Laszlo guy's there.
Laszlo? That asshole? What's he want?
It's Tracy that wants something. She wants to get back on Fame or Shame after you and Uncle T cut her cameo short.
Well, maybe we ought to help her out with that.
Maybe we ought to.
Hey, let me ask you. Back there with your mom. That went okay, didn't it?
Anything that ends with Fabian's burst eardrum is more than okay with me.
Yeah, I mean with me and your mom.
I think it's an important first step in, like, the direction of okay, if you know what I mean. Here's the tattoo shop.
Well, it looks like we're trying to get Michael's life put back together, one step at a time.
I'm looking for something hip that, you know, says I'm capable of violence, but I'm awesome in the sack. So listen, babe. If you want to make it in Vinewood, you got to do whatever it takes. Even if whatever it takes is a depressed borderline alcoholic who hosts the third most popular talent show amongst the 40-year-old female demographic.
So you'll let me on the show if I blow you?
Yes. And if you could wear some black lipstick, the little guy loves the goth vibe.
Oh.
Whoa.
Laszlo.
Dude, that was entirely out of context, bro.
Jim, you find the Inkslinger. Sit on him. Laszlo here is going to have a little cosmetic work done.
No, please.
Whoa. Stay put, you lame-ass Mark.
Sure, kid.
What?
Come on, just not the tongue. I need that for my work. You made me a pouty fucking hipster. Joe! Are you popping a fucking tent over here? Fucking son! Ow!
Oh, that looks pretty. Here, let's get rid of this.
Oh, my God! Papa Bear! What's Daddy Number Two gonna think about this?
Let's not get him involved.
Let's do... that's a clean needle, right? I don't need more Hep C.
Now hold it. You move, and I will knock you into next week.
Mommy!
Should I draw his three pubic hairs?
Oh my gosh.
Nice.
You got like a camera phone or a mirror I can
see? Oh yeah, I'll get you a mirror. Smash you over the head with it. Snip, snip.
Oh, this is a real one-stop shop. You fucking asshole, I'm a celebrity. Oh, no, that's my signature, my ponytail. Now I gotta get extensions.
No, what you gotta get is my daughter, whatever she wants.
Yeah, without sucking on your piddle stick.
Look, okay, guys, that was a joke. I'm a clown. I'm a sad, lonely little clown.
Hey, you're gonna put her on your show, and you're gonna make sure she looks good.
Look, okay, I got a lot of juice in this town, but I mean,
I'm not a miracle.
Just do it! Yeah.
All right.
All right, Trace, let's go. We gotta get to the therapist.
What?
So, I'll, like, call you or something, okay? Bye.
There's ever a family that needs therapy. Don't.
Family therapy. Definitely, that's what we need.
How do I look? It's not good, is it?
Who knew you could use a tattoo gun? It's one of those skills you pick up in prison. You know, inking your name on your cellie's ass. Ew! Are you serious? Come on! No! Not quite.
Not to be difficult, but your therapist hasn't exactly been transformational to your mental health. So I don't know why he'd be better positioned to help four dysfunctionals.
Hey, this was your mother's idea.
Well, I guess it beats yoga.
Huh? Now he beats yoga. Literally. Like babying? Around the head with a laptop? Oh, yeah, like pow! Our old man released the dude's inner tranquility all over the beam machine batting.
To be honest, and I know it's karmically bad, but yeah, I fucking hate that dude.
Yeah, I know, right? He's so up his own ass. You're a fucking contortionist. Whoopee. I contort my junk all day long, and I don't act all superior about it. Just a little ashamed and empty inside.
Overshare.
Hey, guy was talking smack to your mother.
Well, I applaud you, Pop.
Here, here. You're, like, finally, like, using your powers of selfishness and rage for, like, good. Not an objective universal good. But like a subjective, what's in our best interest kind of good.
Fuck yeah, awesome! Let's rob somebody!
Do it, Dad!
Yeah, do it!
Enough, okay? I love that we're getting along, but knock it off.
Yeah, don't like actually rob a liquor store. That might like kill the mood.
Fucking therapy, let's do that shit.
Hey, how about you just let your mom and me talk, okay? We got some issues we gotta iron out.
You
oh gosh.
You could just sit there and be quiet.
I'm stuck now.
I got all the prescriptions I need.
All right, guys. We're going to walk the rest of the way. Come on, guys. Let's walk the rest of the way. Return to your family. Oh, for crying out loud. Honestly. I need to get a car. Obviously, they can't cross the street on their own. There you guys go. In the car. Sometime today. You mean to tell me you were sitting there watching that the whole time?
Amanda!
Hello!
Good to see you again. Michael, I'm so glad. Isn't this great?
Fantastic.
Michael, be positive.
I am being positive. This is me being positive.
Give it up, Michael. The sarcasm. It's one of the reasons I moved out. It's beneath you.
No, it's not, Amanda. Trust me. Nothing's beneath me.
No, normally there's a whore beneath you.
You know, for someone who spends every waking moment working on themselves inside and out, I gotta tell you, the progress has been really fucking slow.
How would you know what progress is like, you stupid murdering shit?
Gee, because all you do is whine at me.
Oh, all I do is whine. Michael, could you please stop murdering people? Michael, could you please stop endangering me and the both of your children? You kill people, and then you sit in the sun and drink and feel guilty about it. That is not work.
I don't see you complaining on the way to the fucking bank.
Ouch.
I mean, let's face it, Amanda. We're trailer trash, you and me. We were taught to do this.
Get a center, Michael. You have no center.
How about you suck my cock? Huh? No, wait. We'll both get a center before that ever happens.
You are such a fucking animal, a deranged animal.
You fucking ain't right, I'm deranged. How could I not be?
I should have had you locked up years ago, you stupid shit.
Do it. I'll put you in the fucking ground with the rest of them.
Ooh.
And that's really all the time we have.
Oh,
great.
I think we made some real progress there.
Oh, Michael, I hope this goes without saying, but family work is a little more expensive.
What, double?
Squared.
Of course.
Take care now.
So you gonna come home with me or what?
Guess we'll give it a try.
All right, then.
Kids! So, will you drive us home?
So I guess the family therapy session didn't work too well.
You know, there was a moment there. I thought...
What?
I don't know, like maybe we still had a ways to go. You know, like maybe we need more time.
Time for what?
Time to move beyond screaming at each other.
That was cathartic.
Catharsis all over my face.
Ooh, I got a warm, fuzzy feeling.
Probably just the meds you rated.
Okay. Cathartic. All right. I just don't want it to be more of the same.
Now you're the one making the demands?
No, not demands. I'm saying you're right. Something was broke, and we gotta work at fixing it.
We do, all of us.
Yes, Mom.
For real, peeps.
Because I started to understand something in there. No one else gets this family. Not Dr. Friedlander, or my yoga teacher, or our tennis coach, or the juice guy, or the dog walker.
Hey.
Or Jimmy's third grade teacher.
Or the trash guy.
Or Dad's proctologist.
Or the guy that thinks he's Jesus on Vespucci Beach.
Or the hippie bum who thinks the world is ending.
We're stuck with each other. I mean, how do you explain faking our deaths, changing our names, all the lying to the FIB? That monster, Trevor.
There's no explaining Uncle T.
Hey, is he coming to the next therapy session?
What? No! No!
The famous getaway driver, Michael Townley!
No! Jeez!
Just one thing, Michael. Don't get us killed. And don't get killed. Can you do that?
I give it my best shot. With every fiber of my being, I will do whatever it takes to make sure it doesn't happen. Promise.
Kids, rooms. If you find dead bodies, cheap women, or Trevor Phillips, we're checking into the Rockford Hills Hotel.
Looks like we got the family back. I'll take it. Any way I can get it. Hope you guys enjoyed some more Grand Theft Auto 5. Looks like family therapy worked. We'll see you guys next time.